Hi everyone, it's the English Simmer here, and welcome back to part 2 of the 13 Souls Challenge here in The Sims 4. I made an error of judgment in the first part. We actually have one of our first traits right here. So Lily Feng has the genius trait, which correlates to the mind essence. So she's gonna be our first victim, I think. We can't kill anyone off until we have actually captured our own essence. And to do that, like I said in the last part, we do have to complete the best-selling author aspiration first before we do kill anyone off, or else Grimm is probably gonna kill us off if we don't listen to him. And I'm not playing around with that. I don't want the Grim Reaper to be all up in my grill and take my girl Paige. So we're gonna actually probably invite Lily for a coffee or something like that. Oh god, she's thinking about fire. She's like, remember that one time I set myself on fire and it all led to this crazy, crazy reaping that I'm now doing for the Grim Reaper, who apparently is like my best friend? Yeah. Good times. So like I said, we're probably gonna hang out with Lily a bit today. No, I don't want to light you. I want to clean that up. How is your fun? It's still not the best, but that's fine. You can stop watching TV for a little while. And what time is it? Oh, it's like 8 a.m. It might be a bit early, but I kind of do want to meet up with her. I don't know. I feel like it might seem a little bit... What's the word that I'm looking for? I'm looking for the word suspicious. That's the word I'm looking for. It might be a bit suspish if we ring her at like 8 a.m. like, hey, wanna hang out? Like, I know I only just met you yesterday, but I kinda wanna hang out with you already. So we'll leave it a little bit. Oh my goodness. She's actually much better at the violin than I expected her to be. I don't know how I feel about the violin. Like, I feel like if it's played really, really well, then I'm like, oh my god, this is amazing. I love it. But even as like a good violin player sometimes, I'm like, ugh, that hurts. Obviously, I don't play the violin. But one of my friends, when we were in school, I think, was learning, and it just, I don't know, I feel like I'm mentally scarred by her practicing. So I feel like even when I hear a really good violin player, even some notes, I'm like, oh, it was probably meant to sound that way, but my ears didn't like the way it sounded. But it's getting Paige's fun up, and that's all we can ask for. She needs to chat with someone. Watch the World Culture Network. That we can do. We are going to be focusing on her whims quite a lot as well, because obviously I do want to get up enough aspiration points to kind of bulk up on as many potion of youths that we can, because we don't have a lot of time to complete this challenge, and it's kind of stressing me out already because we're already on to like 10 days, which is just scary. Are you watching it? Is this the right channel? Watch channel. Apparently this is the right channel. There we go. We completed it. You have to watch it for a little bit then. Become inspired, level up in writing skill. We will definitely be doing that. How many points is that? 100. She also wants to chat to someone, which again we will be doing because I want to invite out. Ignore Medi and his weird custom content. I don't know what he got changed into, but I need to remove it from my game. I need to remove quite a lot from my game. But let's send her a happy text. This is a bit weird, not gonna lie. Like, you only just met the woman yesterday. I feel like she is gonna be like, what? Oh my god, we actually got quite a lot of royalties. That's quite impressive. I'm proud of you, Paige. Oh, here we go. I agree, Paige. It's a great day. Let's go out and enjoy the park. Okay. I mean, technically, we didn't invite her out. We just sent her a text like, hey, really nice to meet you at the library yesterday. That book that you were reading? really good choice. We just sent her a happy text because we were in a good mood and we were feeling like a friendly neighbor, even though she doesn't live anywhere near our neighborhood. She lives in the city. She lives in San Myshuno, but she's a genius and we need that genius trait. So let's discuss our interests with her and what else can we do? We'll give you a heartfelt compliment. Let's go for it. Brighten her day a little bit. And gossip. Come on. Hang out with friends. Technically not our friend yet, but fingers crossed will hopefully become our friend because she has that mind essence that I crave. I also made this challenge like way harder for myself. I actually didn't mention this in the first part, but I made her unflirty, which considering we need to kill off two like spouses or romantic partners, is gonna be quite difficult. Although she is feeling flirty, randomly. How did you get flirty? From juicy gossip. You heard a steamy rumor. Oh my goodness, don't cloud gaze. Don't cloud gaze. Oh my goodness, she is feeling flirty. Let's do an impression. We aren't making moves on Lily, okay? You keep it in your pants, all right? Second part and you're already feeling flirty. Trying to make a friend and you're here all, hey, what if she wants to be more with me? No, Paige. Keep it in your pants. We are not doing that. She's not going to be our romantic interest one. Plus, she's married, girl. I guess we could ask her about her love life. Sure. Let's find out more about Victor. Paige is unflirty. Unflirty Sims get tense around flirty Sims and seldom get flirty around themselves. But you're flirty yourself. Oh no, now she's happy. She's calmed down a little bit from hearing that steamy rumor. She's like, okay, that was enough flirtiness for me. I'm gonna go back to just feeling happy. Right. Oh my god, she's thinking about rainbows and everything. Could you get more gay? Seriously? Just, I told you to keep it in your pants. We aren't getting to that level on part two. It ain't happening. Yes, just talk about the weather. Talk about how it's a nice sunny day. Darling, what do you have? Although I do feel like you're a teenager and I kind of want to avoid killing teens if I possibly can. Did you even find out her traits? No, you did not. Well, that's no good, is it? Discuss latest book. We met you in a library. Surely you like books. Oh, we're just gonna... Oh, I thought we were gonna follow her into the bathroom then. I was like, Paige, you are far too eager. I'm fairly sure the Grim Reaper did not write down in his book of life for you to bloomin' stalk someone into the frickin' bathroom. Public bathrooms, for that matter, as well. Why do these... Why do they have such big heads? What the heck? Why do they look like this? And why do they not have plumbobs above their heads? Where are the plumbobs? I feel like the Sims team missed out a little detail here. Where are the plumbobs? Or maybe it's because Sims don't know that they have plumbobs above their heads. Because they only have them when you're controlling them. So maybe it's to keep them in the daydream that they are definitely not in a simulation game. Everything they do happens by chance, and there definitely isn't a creator who plays as them. I feel like I'm trying to convince myself that that doesn't happen in real life. Imagine if, like, God or whatever you may believe in. Imagine if that was literally the case. Like, we were in a simulation right now. Oh my goodness. The little gardener has tiny little space buns in her hair. She looks adorable. There are a lot of people here to introduce ourselves to. Like, I feel like we could get some good gossip around here. How many lifetime reward points do we have? 760. What does she want to do? Become inspired. Finish reading a book. I locked in the other thing. Where did it go? I have no idea where that went. She also wants to call someone on the phone. So I'm actually going to call someone because I want her to get these points up. Does anyone have... He's mean. That's quite good. With Mitchell being mean, That's another thing that we need. That's the envy essence. So let's chat with him on the phone. Although Mitchell is not a fan of us already. He's already in the red and we've only met him once. Also, I made it 100 times harder because she also has the loner trait. So not only did I make it nearly impossible for her to have a romance with someone, which she needs two for this challenge, I also made her a loner, which makes her be freaking like really, really tense whenever she's talking to a new person. Why do I do this to myself? Why do I look at a challenge rules and then be like, nope, you know what? This isn't hard enough for me. I need to make this harder on myself. And that also means that I don't think she got the points for talking to someone on the phone because she went from being happy. Oh no, she did get it. She got the 25 points. Okay, that's good. She wants to go home and just have a mud bath. Girl, we are not living in luxury, okay? Oh no, she's gonna go join the game of the little cute space bun gardener. Let's get to know her a bit. Whilst we're playing chess with her. Go on, Paige. You got this. I believe in you. You wear glasses. That means you're smart on some people's brains. On some people's brains? I meant in some people's brains. She wants to tell a joke. That I can do. Let's joke about politicians. What was she? She's a foodie. Oh, Kerry, I didn't need that. I didn't need to know that piece of vital information because that just means that I can't use you as a freaking test subject. Can you not do this to me? Can you all just be like Sims that I need in my life? Like good old Lily here. Oh my god. She well just stuck her boobs out for Bjorn to be look, she's sticking her boobs out. She's like, I'ma distract you with all my womanly charms. Check out these tatas. Look, she keeps doing it. Literally just sticking out her boobs. I see why you wore a lacy dress, Feng. I see it in you. See it in your eyes. You just want to win at all these chess matches. So you play with men and distract them with your lacy boobs. What am I even going on about? Like, second part of this challenge and I already feel like I've lost my mind. Let's give him a friendly introduction. Bjorn, what traits do you have? Are you useful to me in any way? Because your wife is not yet. He's gloomy, a slob, and good. I feel like slob is one. Or maybe it was snob. What was he? Good, gloomy, and slob. Good, gloomy, slob. Nope. He is no use to me. You're just about as useful as your dang wife. Which is 0%. Maybe I should just kill the ones who actually aren't useful to me. Genji. Oh my god, that just reminds me of Overwatch. This is what Genji really looks like, guys. All those fit, like, young men that you all draw in your fan art. It's not real. This is what the real Genji looks like without his, like, armor and his face mask. This is who's hiding underneath. Just thought you should know. Feel like you're all being catfished by Genji. Mitchell's down here. Why do you look like a private investigator? Maybe we shouldn't become friends with him because he feels like he might be an investigator. And I kind of don't want all that heat on me. I don't want to be in the limelight. Paige didn't ask to kill people. She just got assigned the job. She's like the Grim Reaper's hitman, basically. That's what she has become. To be fair, I don't even think she's getting paid for it, bless her. Like, she's literally just doing it to get on his good side. Maybe she'll evade death if she does this for Grimm. I don't know. I don't know why we're actually doing this challenge, just because we came across it one day. And when you feel like the Grim Reaper asks you to do something, you don't say no. Because you know he could just take your soul then and there. So you get the 13 souls for him, and you don't even question it. Which does not seem logical to me in the slightest, but we'll roll with it. For the sake of The Sims 4 and this challenge, We will just roll with that piece of information. Perfectionist, materialistic, and a genius. Materialistic is one. We can kill off both the Fengs. That is what I am talking about. Okay, so the Fengs are currently top of my hit list. And they both live in the same apartment, so you know, once we get this best-selling author, two birds, one stone. I'm all about that life. Let's make it easier for myself. Kill off his wife, become the lover of Victor, and then kill him off as well. What could be better than that? Anyway, I feel like we should probably head to the library and get, like, at least one book out of us today. We'll try it anyway. I mean, it's like 4 p.m. I feel like all the libraries in The Sims 4 are 24 hours anyway. Oh my god, demon. If he is actually librarianing? What am I on about? Is that even a word? No, it's definitely not a word. If he is on duty today as the librarian, I'm gonna have to cleanse his sins. I'm gonna steal that spray bottle off him and pray that it is holy water, because the way he is looking right now, he's not looking too fresh. Oh, we got a new librarian today, Rhys Pitino. Well, let's go introduce ourselves to Rhys. New boy on the job, easy meet right there. Go introduce yourself to him. Go on, hopefully he's like a timid librarian. I love how they all wear the same outfits as well. It's so cute. Literally all the librarians wear the same outfits. It's adorable. Let's go introduce ourselves to him. They all have the cat eye glasses on as well. He's a bookworm, he's good, and he is neat. So he has the same trait as us again, which kind of isn't helpful because I already want to kind of kill off Mehdi because he's kind of the first person that introduced himself to us, and he also called us a sinner before he even knew what we were up to. So I feel like we should just live up to our expectation and sin against him. Because what could be better than that? Right, go and try and churn out another book. Let's see if we can do it. Are you going to put that down? Nope, you stuck. Are you just going to sit there? What's going on? Can we move? Paige, put down the iPad. How is this doing something and you're not even touching it? You seriously are being haunted. There's no doubt about it. Strange things are happening here, there, and everywhere. He's definitely watching over us. Don't you dare steal my PC. Don't you dare. I saw you going for that, Rhys. Back away. Pat the Otter! Yes, we can call it. Seriously, Otter fits into like all of these children books names. It's great. I love it. I don't even have to use my imagination and I already am in this challenge. I feel like this is quite imaginative. Props to the creator, who I actually didn't give a shout out to in the last part, but I feel like we should. Do they have like an author's name on it? I feel like they don't have their name on it. I know someone posted about it in the Sims forum, maybe? Or maybe they didn't. Who created you, challenge? Who do I need to give a shout out to? Because I don't like doing things without giving people the proper credit that they deserve, because they were way more imaginative than I was. Who did it? Okay. This has zero name to it. Oh, well, I'll link the challenge again below. They wrote like literally a whole blog on their version of this challenge. They did this back in 2014. That's impressive. So I will link again in the description, because they've written like a whole story about their challenge. I might actually give it a read. Sounds quite good from what I'm seeing. So shout out to you. It is just Synchronomicon. I don't know how to say that word. It's apparently based on the Necronomicon. I don't know. Don't yell at me for not pronouncing that right. Also, I'm recording this video after the teaser has just gone live, so if you saw the teaser of this challenge on Saturday night, a lot of you were like, oh my god, is this based on Death Note? And honestly, I've never watched Death Note the anime, so I would have no idea. I mean, I Wikipedia'd it because I had no clue what it was, and it kind of sounds like the same type of thing, but I think this was based more on the novel that was released in 2006. I have no idea because I'm not the official creator of this challenge, so I don't really know where the creator took inspiration from. I just thought it was a really cool challenge to do. And also when I searched it on YouTube, it didn't have... Oh, look, he's back. He's back to cleaning me. Why are you all the same? What did I ever do to any of you? Who hurt you when you were younger to make you so... So, I don't know, just like judgmental. Really? Can you all just let me live my life, please? But yeah, I don't know where the original inspiration came from, but it's an awesome challenge and I think I'm really gonna have fun with it. And I hope you guys are gonna have fun with it as well, either doing your own or watching this challenge and getting enjoyment out of this. I feel like Paige is a very likable character. She's kind of as weird as Eden, but Eden was a bit more in my Black Widow challenge, for those of you who haven't watched it. Eden was a bit more, I don't know what you would call it, kind of like you would look at her and you would be like, yeah, you're a gold digger. You have probably killed some men in your past to get where you are today. Whereas I feel like you look at Paige and she just looks so pure and innocent that no one would ever suspect her, which is why I feel like she's a great character to have in this challenge. I just feel like she has a lot of personality about her and I'm really gonna get into her story. I mean, I already am. I love the fact that she wants to be a best-selling author and has had that dream from being a child. However, now it kind of has some more meaning behind it because it's being influenced by the Reaper himself, who we need to go catch up with. I might do an every Friday night session. We might catch up with Grimm and be like, hey buddy, what's crackin', you know? We set up this this Friday midnight time slot for every Friday, just so we could catch up, you know, maybe have a brew. That was one of the most English things that's ever come out of my mouth. Have a brew, have a bit of a catch up, just sit down on a Friday night in our haunted little abandoned house and see how I'm going. See how killing 13 people is going. However, we haven't killed a single soul yet. I feel like it's going to take a while, which is why I might do some of this, like, best-selling author off-screen, because I don't just want to be writing books constantly in front of you guys. Although she is almost finished with this one. I'm hoping it's going to be an excellent book, because that would really help towards these five excellence. And she's almost at level 6 of the writing skill, which again is definitely going to help with those excellence. So please, let's just do this. Just proper smash the last few pages out. You got this. It's almost 10 p.m. We need to go home. Why are you shuddering so much? What's going on with you? Is it because you're a loner and you're getting like stranger danger? I'm very confused because she's here just like, and I don't really know what she's doing. Maybe we should stick our headphones on so no one can really talk to us. Oh, there we go. We finished writing a book. Nice. There's another one in our inventory. So let's go home. First off, we're gonna do a pee because we are desperate, which also might be why she's been shivering this entire time. Oh, Medi's fixed himself. He no longer looks like a demon, which is quite nice. So yeah, let's go do a pee and then we will sell to publisher. Pat the Otter is going to be sold. And Pat was also 1 out of 5 of an excellent book. Cheers, Pat. That's so nice of you. Thanks for offering yourself as an excellent for me. Why am I watching my simpy? Let's not do that. I am gonna end this part here though, guys. So thank you all so much for watching the second part of this challenge. I hope you are all enjoying it. Let me know in the comments down below. Also, give it a big thumbs up if you are enjoying it. It lets me know that you want to see more of these videos more frequently. I am having so much fun with this, and I feel like I'm gonna have so much fun with it even in the future. I cannot wait to properly dive into this, but thank you all so much for watching, and I will speak to you all in the next part. Bye, guys!